Hello everyone, welcome back in my channel. In this video we discuss the some basic concept of set theory, the way of representation of the sets and the some types of the sets. So let's begin. The theory of set was developed by German mathematician George Cantor. He first encountered set while working on problems on trigonometric series. In this video, we discuss some basic definitions and operation involving sets. Set. A well-defined collection of objects is called a set. The objects belonging to a set are called its members or elements. The sets are denoted by capital alphabets ABC and the elements are denoted by small letter ABC. There are some examples of the sets. Here the set of children's, the set of flowers and the set of books. Representation of a set. A set can be represented by the following two ways. The first method is roster form. In this method, all the elements of the set are written within bracket. For example, if A is equal to a set of vowels, then the set A is represented as A, E, I, O, U within curly bracket. And the second method is the set builder form. In this method, we list the properties satisfying by elements of the sets. For example, if A is equal to a set of prime numbers less than 15, then A can be written as A is equal to X such that X is the prime number less than 15. Here colon stand for the such that. Notation. In the set theory, we use the so many notation. Here A is the elements of A. If any elements belong to the set A, we write the A element belong to the A. Here 3 belong to the set A, we write here the 3 is the element of A. The X is not element of A. This represent the set, this represent the subset, this represent proper subset, and this represent not subset. Let's see the various types of the sets. Empty sets. A set consisting of no elements at all is called an empty set. It is also called null set or the void set. It is denoted by a symbol phi or a curly bracket. For example, X says that X belongs to the natural number and the X lie between 3 and 4. So there is no any natural number that exists which lie between 3 and 4. So this set is the empty set. Singleton set. A set consisting of one element only is called a singleton set. For example, here the set A consists only one element 3, so this set A is called singleton set. Finite set. A set having a finite number of elements is called a finite set. For example, A is called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here the number of elements are finite, so the set A is called the finite set. Infinite set. A set having an infinite number of elements is called an infinite set. For example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and dot dot. Here dot dot represent the infinite number of elements of the set A. Cardinal number of set. The number of distinct elements in a set A is called its cardinal number. It is denoted by N. For example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then N is equal to 5. Equal set. Two sets A and B are said to be equal if every element of A is in B and every element of B is in A. It is written as A is equal to B. For example, the A is equal to 2, 3, 5, 7 and B having elements 7, 3, 5, 2, therefore A is equal to B. The equivalent set. Two sets A and B are said to be equivalent if number of element of A is equal to number of element of B. For example, in the set A having the number of element of 5 and the B also having the number of element of 5, then N is equal to NB. Subsets. If A and B are two sets such that every element of A is in B, then set A is said to be the subset of B and it is written as A is the subset of B. For example, if A is equal to 2, 3 and B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, then A is the subset of B and B is the superset of A and it is written as B the superset of A. properties of subset. Every set is a subset of itself, means A is the also subset of itself, A. Empty set is the subset of every set, means phi is the subset of A. Note, the number of subset a set having n distinct element is 2 power n.